Right guys, I'm suited up and it's paint day. I can't do any more, I've done the best I can. You saw in the quick bit at the start of the video, I painted the undersides of the doors, the boot lid, number plate lamp. Previous night to that, painted the boot hinges, the internal hinges and the inside of the boot lid. So now we've got the two doors and the actual main shell to paint. So I've just been around now, we've panel wiped it all. Just got to do the best I can now, so sit back and enjoy hopefully some good painting. Some bits of dust and stuff what I did last night. I'm under a carport and I've done the best I can, so I'll set you guys up and let's get going. Right, so it's really hard to see in this light, but I'm about to do coat number three. Like I say, the light's awful, we'll get you out, or this booth down. But there's some bits in the paint, but I can't do a lot about that. I've got a run there I'm really annoyed about, but yeah, pretty happy at that so far. Let's see how it dries. Third coat, it could all go wrong yet, but the vision is coming. I've not gone mad in the engine bay. I just wanted it to be the right colour really. It gets covered up with a lot of stuff. She's not going to be show car used, but really happy so far. The colour is phenomenal. So full credit to my other half for picking that. It's beautiful. But,
and she's outside mixing paint.
And she's outside mixing paint, as she's just said. Yeah, I'll give you a quick walk around just while it's flashing off. Can't do too much because I need to be able to breathe. But we're getting there, we're getting there. We'll see. See how she looks dry. It's a bright yellow. Well, I say bright, it's very mustardy, but it's really bright. So I haven't filmed loads and loads of the painting. It got to the point where I just really need to concentrate and get on with it. But it's yellow. Yeah, I've done three coats, which is what I advised for the paint shop as well. Got a coat to flat. It's going to need a flat back. There's quite a bit of dust in it. The scuttle, where the flat areas basically, where the dust could settle, has gone on it. Probably not everyone's cup of tea to leave the boot area exposed and the inside, but obviously that is freshly painted. It's been hoovered and wiped out. I didn't get any dust come out of there, and I didn't see the point in introducing more dust by having all my paper and cellophane and stuff rattling around in the wind, because I'm struggling enough with the booth. But the booth's done really well, so big thanks to my other half for that. But yeah. It's got a nice finish. So what I'll do is I'll show you around the car properly. So how would I rate the experience of doing this? very enjoyable and very rewarding, but hard work. You know, the whole point of this was to get the car to a painted shell for 1500 quid at home, yourself, everything yourself. It's hard work. There's people that pay £3,000 to £4,000 to have a Mini professionally prepared and just painted, and then not to mention the labour costs of welding the car up. So I've actually done a total up of what it would have cost me to give it to a professional, and we're going to cover all the budget, see where we got. Did we smash it? Did we go over it? Did we come under it? What do you all think? The budget's completely up to date, and I'll obviously show you at the end of this video. Budget's completely up to date, but obviously I've got my paint and materials to add on, and then I'm going to add on surplus stuff like a few rattle cam primers I've had, some sandpapers, discs, stuff like that. You can go really finicky and start putting electricity into it, but we're not doing that. So I will include in for that because I think it's important. But yeah, let's have a quick look around the car, see where we're at, see how well I did. Right, so you can just see there's some slight bits in it where it's laid very, very slightly. Places on the car is a little bit dry. I don't know if I'm getting used to it. The whole thing's new to me. Engine bay I've really not gone mad with. It's got a really nice shine to it. But bear in mind, getting it covered up, built up and stuff like that. Not gone mad with it really. I really haven't gone mad prepping it. But I mean, there's areas of it that are just absolutely beautiful. So you think this corner especially was accident damaged. So really, really nice. Obviously once I take this booth down, the light of it will change. And it'll look very, very different. I've got one run. You can jump off a cliff there, and that's a little bit like, jump into a jumping off Mount Everest there. But considering the whole car, I've not found another run yet on all these panels. Remember this panel here? It was quite bad. It was all sticking out, it was all wavy, and it's not 110, but come on guys, first time I've done that. One thing I'm really happy with on the whole car, I've not gone over the whole thing yet, but I've got no sanding scratches, and that was the biggest fear. The sanding scratches on the sidewalk in areas, and it annoys me a little bit when I look at it. But yeah, there's areas of the car which are just a bit dry. We're a couple hours after it now, so the car's touched dry. I blew inside the boot a little bit, it's another reason why I left it open. All the valance. This quarter, the bane of my life, really hasn't come out too bad. So once again, we'll finish this video with the cellophane out of the way, but first initial fresh look at it. So yeah, hit in the comments below what you think. Did the best I could. I'll run through when I finish this video at the board, and at the end, the spray gun I use and stuff like that. It's basically an all round one by the Build Bliss. And yeah. Right guys, it's the next day. Paint's still on the car, so that's a plus. I hope you enjoyed the walk around then. That was with the booth taken down and you could see it in proper daylight. That was later the evening I painted it. The paint's obviously in its drying process now. It's going to cure. I've walked around the car and shown you all the bits. There's dust in it. There's one run on the back. There's some dry patches in the paint. I'm not a professional. I don't profess to be either. I've done the best I can. I'm quite happy with it. I hope I can save it, flat back and stuff like that. But if you look back at what I've achieved and how far it's come, I think that's, let's be frank, that's not a bad achievement. So it's not perfect. Never expected it to be perfect, but I'm happy with it. People can pick holes in it and do what they want, but I can hold my head high knowing I've saved this car. It's not been on road since 2001. It's now going to start its full rebuild process. It's not accident damaged anymore. It's got all new panels, all new metal, and I've done the best I can with it. If we can enjoy it and drive it, have fun with it, can't ask anything else. So in this video, I'm going to tell you the hours, and then in the next video, I'll do a full total up. We'll do a full walk around of the car again. I'm going to start putting the doors back on because they're in my house at the moment and stuff like that. And we will actually have a full episode on, number one, did I get the budget? Did I come close? Did I go over it? Am I under it? All the things. Number two, I'm also going to then add the sandpapers and some of my consumables because I have kept notes of stuff. So obviously bear that in mind as well. That's stuff you should always have in your garage if you're going to do this work, but I will include it in the total. If we go over the budget, you know, let's not be mad at it. Look what we've achieved. Right guys, that brings this episode to a close. Right back at the beginning of this series, I had to get a car to a painter's shell for £1,500. That was my target, including the cost of buying it. So if you followed along all the way through this, you'll know that the car cost me £500 and we've been adding it up as we go. I'm going to do a full episode at the end. Next episode will be a full breakdown of the budget. You'll be able to see where I've spent money and, you know, where it's cost. At the moment, we're at £1,284.84. So, you know, we're close. I know the figure. Personally added it up. Obviously, that's buying materials for this now. But we will include that in the next episode. But I really wanted to quickly leave you guys with a quick bit of food for thought. So on a rough sort of figure on the back of my head, I have spent 248 hours getting it from October till now, to what you see, all the work, all the restoration work, the paint, everything. That's how long it's taken to get it to a painted shell. So if you break that down, it's about 31 days if you're working an 8-hour day. So that's about a month really, if you look at it roughly, a rough month. But to break it down even further, an average hourly rate for a garage, maybe £25 an hour, which is very cheap for a body shop these days, and more £40-50 an hour these days. But to break it down to the lowest, so £25 an hour equates to £6,200. So I wanted to leave you guys with that. That's what I've saved doing this all myself. Might not be for everyone, but the whole point of this is to get people into their cars, into the classics. People said it couldn't be done. You know, it's an accident damaged car front and back as well. So I've had a lot of challenges along the way, but I like to think I've overcome them. I did pick a Clubman, which made it a bit more expensive, but I can't look at it. Why wouldn't you pick a Clubman? A lot of people comment it's got the wrong front end on it, but I love it. You know, it's awesome. So I'm going to leave you guys with that little bit of food for thought. The next episode is going to be breaking down the costs. I put my consumables in there. And did we come close to 1500? You know, if we go past 1500, is that really that bad? You know, if we're under it, that's awesome. But let's see what we get on with. So I'm going to leave you with one question. Would you like to see this car being rebuilt on the channel? The budget's obviously stopped now. We've hit the budget. We've got, you know, a painted shell. Would you like to see it being restored? As in rolling car, get it built up, build out all my spares. I'm going to raid spares, got stuff with the car, and I'm going to have to buy new bits, gaskets, bushes. Raid an engine that I've got in storage, because obviously I'm seized for this car and I've not worked on that yet. Would you like to see it being rebuilt? It'll be a few how-to videos maybe, and then it'll be obviously update videos, how we're going. We're going to crack back on a V89, and we have another car coming to the channel in a few weeks' time. So let me know what you think in the comments. Let me know what your thoughts are. Do you think I've done it? Do you think I haven't? But I'm quite proud of what I have achieved. Obviously, I know the final figure. And we'll check back with you in the next episode for that. So thank you for watching for this whole series. It's been awesome. I really enjoyed it. I've loved all the comments and the feedback. I hope people have gone out there, they've started to work on their cars, or they bought projects and gone, hey, I'm going to do it. He can do it. I can do it. Do it. The car's not moved from that spot on the driveway. It's not gone anywhere. It's not left my house. So you can do it. And I don't have an amazing array of tools, you know, I've just collected them over the years. You can do it. So catch you next one, guys. Please stay safe and let's work that budget out next.